Yeah, I'm writing an exam today. It's gonna be a pretty hard one, so I hope the students study. Yeah, most of them are doing pretty well in the class, but... What is that? I think it's a body. I gotta call you back.
CSI David, make sure you check those pockets.
Yeah, she doesn't have any pockets, boss.
Oh, okay. Looks like this party ended early.
Hey guys, so you probably only see this in movies and TVs, but people like this really exist. So they've collected data from my crime scene and now it's their job to analyze it and see who my killer was.
Oh, hey Tanya, what are you working on?
Oh, hi Suzanne. I'm working on the case of the young woman that was killed on the college campus. I'm going through the evidence to try to determine her killer. Since my specialty is DNA, I'll be analyzing the DNA evidence.
So in terms of evidence, where does DNA come from?
Oh, DNA comes from numerous sources. It can come from your hair with the root attached, blood, saliva, semen. You can even get a DNA profile from mitochondrial DNA from just normal hair. That's how the serial killer, the Grim Sleeper, was killed. Or found. Not killed.
Wow, that's pretty cool. So how important is DNA when it comes to linking a suspect to a crime?
Oh, DNA is really important because it links the victim directly with the suspect and it can set an innocent suspect free.
So what are the most important things to remember when you're analyzing DNA?
The first thing is not to contaminate your sample. So when you have a DNA swab with blood on it, you want to make sure that it doesn't touch other blood samples, or you don't want to spit or get your saliva on it. Another thing to remember is to always run a control. Controls are important because if you don't run them, you can send an innocent person to jail or send a criminal free.
Wow, that sounds pretty serious.
Yeah, it really is serious. For example, when you see a crime scene, this is the suspected murder weapon. You know, how do we know that this is actually blood or not? To test that, you have to run a positive and negative control.
Wow, I never knew that all this went into testing a single sample of blood. And when it comes to analyzing DNA, it must be even more complicated.
Yeah, it's a long process, but you can't be too certain when you're dealing with someone's freedom.
So, what evidence do you have there?
Well, I have some hair samples, and I have some fibers, and I think I have some plant material as well.
Oh yeah?
Well, I have to figure out first if the hair is from human or from animal. And I also have to figure out if there's still roots attached to the hairs.
Okay, that makes sense. So, what are you doing on your notebook?
Well, I'm documenting the evidence. So first, I'm writing down the number on the envelope. And then I'm recording my observations about it. So this means that first I look at the number on the envelope, I look at the sample, I look at the sample under the microscope, and then I record notes on my sample. I also make sure I only work with one sample at a time because that way I can make sure that I don't confuse which sample goes with which envelope.
Oh wow, that makes sense.
Looks like we're walking into the lab to meet with the lab director.
Is the big boss ready?
He is. Go right on in.
So, what kind of advice do you have if I really want to make it in this biz? I'm talking about I want to crack the Black Dahlia code.
Okay. Well, if you really want to make it in the biz and get a chair like this and a tie like this, here's what you need to do.
Talk to me.
You've got to be organized.
Okay.
You have to know how to work efficiently.
Got my notebook.
Okay. Notes look good. You have to be organized. You have to know how to work efficiently, and you have to make sure that you've done good testing. And I said it before and I'll say it again, the most important thing you need to do is to be able to record your evidence in your lab book, okay? From beginning to end, in detailed manner.
Most important thing, most lab book, details.
The information in the lab book. The lab book itself is pointless if you haven't done a good job of putting the information in.
I'm getting it. I just have one more question.
Okay, fire away.
If I want to be successful in the CSI business, what would a typical schedule look like?
Well, it's a very good question. It would vary, but I would say that probably from day one, the first thing you want to do is develop a strategy. You want to know how you're going to go about sorting your evidence that you've attained, how you're going to record that evidence, and then how you're going to track it. Okay. And again, it's critically important for you to remember that the evidence is linked to facts. So this is not a guesstimate; it has to be linked to facts. You have to determine what evidence you're going to be testing, how you're going to test it, the chain of controls, and again, making sure that all your information is written down in your lab book, because you want to make sure that you can link the evidence to the subject. The next thing I would think is you want to get your DNA information together, and then once you have all that together, then I'm going to say the next thing you want to do is you want to get your arrest warrants together and send out your arrest warrants, because you want to make sure that you can contain your suspect as quickly as possible. Okay. And after the arrest warrants are prepared, then it's time for you to get ready for court. And again, remember that when you're being called to go to court, you're going as an expert witness. And so you need to make sure that you can verify all of your samples, how your samples were gathered, how they were handled, that chain of custody, how they were tested, which tests you use to verify, and which tests you use to refute information, and basically how you came to the conclusion that you did once you get on the stand, because again, you are the expert witness, and it's your attorney. The attorney in the case is going to be primarily on your testimony to win their case.
I got it.
Peter.
Thanks, Dr. B.
You're gonna do good, my man.
All right.
Look forward to it.
Sounds like these guys really know what they're talking about. I have complete confidence you'll be able to find my killer and bring him to justice. Now I can rest in peace. Thanks, guys, for coming.
Give me a better.
OMG. Whenever you're ready.
Your big part. Looks like this party ended early. Looks like this party ended early. Beautiful.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Looks like this party ended early.
Blinking. Sorry. Try again. Are you zooming in, or can we stop now?
So, this case,
blah, blah. Oh, that's good.
I know we're just staying
at that. Yeah, I know. Stamp that, yeah.
Jason, on the DNA of the crime, DNA of the person, cut. Cut.
Well, you can't call cut. Only
cut.
I need to turn my page. That went well.